gene mutates, and an ascomycetia, candida, ergot, cordyceps, aspergillus, any one of them could become capable of burrowing into our brains and taking control, not of millions of us, but billions of us. Billions of puppets with poisoned minds, permanently fixed on one unifying goal: to spread the infection to every last human alive by any means necessary.
So if that happens,
we lose.
Oh, The Last of Us has just kicked off its second season, once again leaving fans wondering, could a fungus really infect billions of people?
Well, researchers at the Field Museum are working to understand the diversity and biogeography of fungi. Matt Nelsen joins us with more. Welcome to the show. You're a senior researcher. And you are part of a mushroom group.
It's true.
This is with a very fancy name. Will you tell us?
The Illinois Mycological Association. And there's people who study fungi.
Yeah, there's like 400 of you.
Yeah. Exactly. It's a group of local people who are interested in going out and trying to document fungal diversity and learn about different fungi.
Now, do you guys have a night where you go out and watch The Last of Us every episode together?
We haven't yet, but we do have special talks periodically and outings in the field where we go out and kind of teach each other about the different mushrooms and other fungi we're finding.
So. All right, so we need to teach you to teach us, because this is top of mind for everybody who's seen the show. Is that possible?
Right, so there are some fungi that are that do infect humans, but most of them don't. And this fungus on the show is based on a fungus in reality, but it's not one that actually infects humans. So this is a fungus that is restricted to insects. And so here's one that infects these ants. That's probably kind of difficult to see. But what it does is it manipulates their behavior and causes them to climb up trees and die, and then they decompose the insides of it, make spores, and infect a new ant on the ground.
So the series is taking something that's happening to ants from this particular mushroom and saying, what if this happened to humans?
Correct.
Then it could lead itself to an apocalyptic, you know,
correct,
takeover of the world.
Correct.
And zombies.
What,
correct,
is that what we're seeing right now? This is the process
in these,
like, fast motion?
You're right, yeah. So one of these ants being infected here.
Get out of here.
This is a group that's been infecting ants and other insects for millions of years, and that's kind of why we don't think there's much of a chance that it would jump to humans, that humans are, we're just so different from these
The mushroom is taking over the ant's body, and you can see the mushrooms growing out of it, just like in the series, because then the zombies look like they have mushrooms growing out of them.
Exactly.
Oh, wow.
Exactly.
Okay, so.
So once the ant dies or the insect dies, then it forms these kind of structures that come out, so they digest the insides, and then this is their version of a mushroom
that
they're making.
Okay, yeah, hold it right there. That way we can get a look at it.
That is the... What is that?
That was the ant, right?
That is the ant.
This one in my right hand here is a ant on a twig, that died on a twig,
okay,
and it has that mushroom coming,
yes,
out of it. This is some sort of a larva that got infected, and that stalk there is the reproductive, kind of where the spores come out.
Beautiful.
We have a caterpillar here. This is from New Zealand, so we have some caterpillars with some really big stalks kind of coming out of that.
Very eerie, but slightly beautiful, have to
say.
So
this is something that, that the researchers on the show must have talked to some people like yourself, because it's based on something that could have possibly happened to an animal, just not a human at this
point.
Exactly. Yeah.
Correct.
All right, any mushrooms we need to be worried about? That's why I'm just curious. Anything?
There's definitely some, like, never eat a mushroom if you don't know if it's something you can eat or not, because there's a lot of poisonous mushrooms out there. So be sure you know what you're doing if you do that. And this group, the Illinois Mycological Association, is one where people are kind of taught what's edible and not edible.
I have friends in Michigan, and they're like, oh, I found this beautiful lion's mane in the woods, and I'm going to cook it up. And I'm like, I don't know if I want to. Do I know that you know which mushrooms
You've
are edible?
You've got to get Matt's number.
You just want to be, you want to be careful, because some could be deadly.
Right. Like, how do you know for sure? Like, you should
go to... It's a lot of practice, and there's no, like, easy rule, sadly. Like, people sometimes like to say, well, if it looks this way, maybe it's safe or not safe. But there aren't any really easy rules of thumb, unfortunately. And so it's a lot of practice and...
And at the Field Museum, you guys have all of these behind-the-scenes looks that people can get of what you just showed us, way more as well, correct?
Yeah. Exactly, yeah. So the museum's just a wonderful place. We have millions of collections, just a fraction of which are on display to the public. And next week, we have an event coming up called Members Night. It's an annual event we have, and so people who join the museum, become members of the museum, are able to come behind the scenes where they aren't normally able to go and see some of these specimens, talk with some of the scientists back there. It's a really fun time for, you know, the members as well as for us as researchers getting to share our passion with everyone.
And Matt, when you're talking about studying like this whole, what is this umbrella of what includes a fungi, and there's lichens, there's mushrooms, there's what? By the way, I love that your sweater is the color of a mushroom.
There you go.
But what's all under the umbrella?
Right. So fungi is kind of a broad term that encompasses a group that's actually more closely related to animals than it is to plants. And it includes things like mushrooms, these lichens, molds, yeasts that we use for bread and beer, a lot of different things. So some of them are good, some of them are bad. A lot of them are just out there hanging out, doing what they do.
Before we let you go, too, tell everybody what your shirt says that your sister got you.
Oh, yeah. So my sister got me a shirt that says, I'm a fun guy, and people liken me. So it's
that's
kind of a double
amazing
whammy.
Yes.
I have to ask one more quick question. Oh, yeah. As somebody that, you know, cooks with mushrooms, everyone out there, we're told, like, you're not supposed to wash the mushroom.
You want to kind of get some of the dirt off of them, but sometimes you can lose some of the flavor if you wash them too much. But just make sure you cook them well, because that
otherwise it could kill you.
I'm getting the dirt off of mine. I'll lose the flavor for that. Matt, thank you so much for sharing your expertise with us. For more information, you can head to fieldmuseum.org. Of course, find them on Facebook and Instagram as well.